Okay, Tijan lap. It's as I said, translates to a moist cake. It's traditionally eaten by miners. It's basically a fruit cake. It's got quite a bit of spice in it. We've got traditional, you know, butter, sugar, flour. Chuck in some raisins, which have been soaked in some tea, just to moisten them. Got some allspice going in there, give it a little bit of kick. Bit of orange, bit of lemon, and then I'm going to serve that with some figs, which we'll come on to. So, first up, we've got the butter and the sugar. Just being blended down, and the longer you do this, the lighter it'll become, and you really want that sugar to start dissolving. So, into there, gently pouring the eggs.
Thing as a Welsh cake. This is different.
You'll have to speak up, Dana.
This isn't the same kind of thing as a Welsh cake, is it?
No, not in the slightest. This is a fruit cake. In the traditional sense, a thick, sort of, you know, soft textured fruit cake. Welsh cake, entirely different ball game. Okay, so slowly adding the eggs, just to make sure the mix doesn't split. If it does, just add a fistful of flour. Okay, so chuck a little bit of flour in there. Let's get these eggs in. Then we get the spices. Right.
I have never seen such energetic cake making in my life. You must be exhausted.
One-handed cake making. Right. Okay, so the allspice. Roughly 3 teaspoons, something like so. 1.
A precision.
Is that not how you make cakes, though?
No.
Okay, that's going in. I've got some tea-soaked raisins. You could soak them in booze. A bit of rum would be nice if you wanted to change the recipe. Okay, I mean, and again, you could... I mean, in the restaurant, we serve this with an Earl Grey tea ice cream.
Oh, so that would be lovely.
So you could soak that in Earl Grey tea, which would be sort of a nice...
Oh, you've
nice
got to make that, Matt, one day. I'd love to taste that.
Okay, so flour going in there. Let's get the zest in.
Do you like baking?
I do. The one thing that bores me is the weighing of ingredients and the precise nature of baking.
I just like that.
You know? Okay, bit of orange, bit of lemon, give it a bit of zest, bit of twang. Okay, and fold it in the flour.
Fold it.
And you don't want to... You don't want to be whisking in flour, because the more you handle it, the heavier it becomes. You start working the gluten, and the cake will become very, very dense.
You're not going to have enough left to get.
Yeah, try and keep it all, obviously, in the bowl.
This okay. is baking in the chef way, isn't it? It's masculine baking.
Glad you say that. Right, okay, so in the tin, just greased and lined, so because you don't want to go to the effort. And then it all sticks to the bottom of the tin. What palaver that would be.
Is this popular at the restaurant?
Yeah, it's delicious.
Because it's Welsh, they all order it.
Because it's what? Because it's Welsh.
Welsh.
yeah, no, it's nice to sort of, you know, look at those traditional things. Okay, so that's going to go in the oven now, 180 degrees for about an hour or until you put a knife through and it comes out nice and clean.